What's up, everyone, and welcome to the club. If you've watched Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness, then you'll definitely recognize this character. In today's video, I'll guide you through each of the steps that I use to draw ink and color Gargantos in the most easiest and simplest way. Let's begin today's lesson by roughly sketching out the pose and proportions of our character. We're gonna start over on the left side of our page. Let's sketch a circle. Starting from the very top, we're gonna lightly work our way around towards the bottom of our circle. Go all the way up towards the top. Now the circle doesn't have to be perfect, I'm just using this as a guide. Now with the circle in place, we're gonna start blocking out the arms. Let's start over on the left side. We're just gonna bring this arm coming down, go across towards the middle, spin this back out towards the left side, going up towards the tip. Now you wanna add some thickness to the arm. Starting from the tip, I'm gonna go a little bit thicker as we go all the way around. And I want to bring that back up towards the bottom of our circle. Let's layer another arm in behind. Starting from the bottom of our circle, curve this around, go up, and we'll bend that out towards the end. And then again, we're going to add some thickness to the arm. Starting from the tip, go a little bit wider as we come down. Just pull that up towards the bottom right of our circle. Now I'm going to draw another arm holding up a car. Let's start from the bottom, curve this around, go up towards the right. Now it's going to wrap this around, pull that in, and then up. Now let's thicken up that arm. Stepping over, going wider, and then narrow as you go out towards the end. Just crossing the arm and going up towards the tip. Now I'm going to place the car inside this gap. So let's start from this point, draw a straight angle line going up, and we're just blocking out the car, go all the way over towards the right, draw that same angled line. Let's close off the top, and then the bottom. Let's add some shape to the car. Starting from the top corner, angle this up and out. Now I'm going to draw that same angle line on the other corners. And it'll connect the ends with a straight line. Let's add another arm coming along the back. Starting from the right side of our circle, come down, go across the car, going up, and we'll bend that back out towards the top. Let's add some thickness, coming around, down towards the bottom, then back up underneath the circle. Now we're going to add some tinier arms along the back. Let's start from the left side, bring out and in, bend that back out, and then again, just tapering that back in so it gets wider, coming back in towards the circle. Let's add a couple more. Starting from the top right, going up and out, bend that up towards the top, and then thicken that up. Let's add another smaller arm on the left side, going across, in, and then back out. And again, just adding some thickness along the inside. Now to help balance out our character, we're gonna add one more arm in the back. Let's start down here, curve around, go across, pull it in, and then up in the middle. And then from the inside, step over, and again, just adding some thickness, going around, go all the way towards the right, then up towards the tip. And place the eye towards the right side, looking towards the car. Let's start from the bottom left side. Start by curving this up and out towards the right side. And then from the right, we'll step in for the bottom of the eye, coming down and then back up. Let's add a fold underneath the eye, coming down and then up. Let's shift the iris and pupil towards the bottom right with a half circle, just aiming towards the car. And we'll pull the brow coming down along the top, coming down, and then up. Now I want to place some spikes along the top of the head. Let's start up here, for this up and out. Taper that back in. Now it's going to work our way across towards the right side. Now I'm going to move over and bend these spikes out towards the left. Going up and out, back down, then add a few more. Now let's go back and add a little bit more shape and detail to the car. From the top, we're going to step down, draw a straight line going across. From the bottom, we'll step up, draw another straight line. From the outside of this line, go straight up toward the top of the roof, and close this off. From the top left, step over, angle this down toward the trunk, and then go across. Now we're going to draw two ovals on the bottom of the car for the tires. Starting off at the top, angle this down towards the left, and another one along the bottom. Once we have a rough sketch, we're going to go back and lightly erase some of these guidelines. Now that we have our clean drawing, we're going to go in with the Sharpie pen and start adding some details and refining our lines. Let's start with the eyes. Starting from the top of the brow, I'm just going to add some more shape and detail as we go. Just folding the bottom of the eye underneath, going around, and then I'm going to switch back and forth with a finer tip pen and add the finer details. Adding some folds and wrinkles underneath the eye. And from the eye, we're just going to work our way out. There are little spikes along the top. So adding some spikes along the bottom of the head. And I'm also layering the back arm on top. Just simplifying the shape of the car, going in behind the arm. Now from here, we're just gonna add some shadows along the bottom edge of each of the arms. So starting on the left side, just gonna draw these short lines going across. And we'll just taper that out towards the bottom. And from here, I'm just going to add some darker shadows on the back side of each arm. Now I'm just adding some thicker wrinkles across each of the arms. use our fine tip pen to add the little details. Now these finer lines are going to allow us to add some more shape to our drawing. Just by adding some more lines along the outside of the arms, and just pulling them in, we create this illusion of a highlight in the center. So enhancing the shadows. Now that we've inked in our drawing, we'll go back and erase our sketch lines. I'm just going to add a rough shadow along the bottom of our character, just to help ground this on the bottom of our page. And just like a coloring book, we'll start filling in our drawing. Start by adding an orange tone along the bottom edge of the arms. And we'll just blend that up. With a bright orange, we'll fill in the iris going around that highlight. Also going to add a shadow along the top of the eye coming down from the eyelid. Now we're going to go in with a light green along the top edge of the arms and body and just blend that down. And this will help create that highlight. Now we're going to fill the rest of the body and arms with this darker green and just blend that out towards the side. And we'll fill our car with this light blue, starting along the top, and then a darker blue along the left side to create a shadow. And as we begin to wrap up our drawing, I'll tighten up my blending and add some shadows. And there we have it. There's a drawing of Gargantos. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. If you did, please make sure you subscribe because I'm posting new lessons every single day. You can also drop your requests in the comments below. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.